स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप ऑल यू आर वेल एंड रिवाइजिंग योर स्टडीज ऑन द डेली बेसिस. माई सेल्फ मिसेस कनक उदासी, सोशल साइंस टीचर इन होली आर्ट्स एजुकेशनल अकेडमी रायपुर. स्टूडेंट्स, आई हैड ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड द चैप्टर लैंड सोयल एंड वाटर रिसोर्सेज. इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव डिस्कस विद यू अबाउट द वाटर रिसोर्सेज. इन वाटर रिसोर्सेज आई हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द water uses, water distribution on earth, etc. Now in this video I am again going to discuss the more topics on water resources, that is about the water resources in India, how much quantity of water is available in India and how much we are consuming and what is the main source of water in India. And apart from this, I am also going to include one more topic, that is the water conservation, how we will conserve the most needed resources on earth, that is the water. Let's have a look on the chart to understand this better. Towards the India's water resources, see students, out of 100% of fresh water, 4% of world's fresh water resources India is using. And in precipitation is the main form of water that India is getting, means in the form of rainfall. The amount of water which we are evaporating from India because in the during the monsoon during the entire year is 4000 cubic kilometer, and what we are receiving back is 2047 cubic kilometer, means we are receiving good amount of water as a back. Now water is unevenly distributed in India as well. In mountainous area, water is there because of presence of the perennial rivers in there, and because of the presence of the glaciers, that glaciers will melt and it will again give back the fresh water. So water is present in very best quality in the mountainous region. In the the people living near around the mountainous regions receive fresh water from the mountains. Now second is plain area. Plains area also consists of large water bodies, so there is also the water is present in good quantity, but majority of population is living there, so because of consumption of so many humans, the water level is becoming low. And in plateaus area, water is roughly presented, not presented same everywhere. Because of the hard rocks, it is very difficult to generate the underground water there as well. So we can say that in India, water is unevenly distributed, and river serves as a main purpose for the entire India. In the northern parts, perennial rivers are serving the purpose, and in southern parts, peninsular rivers are serving the purpose. But during the summer area, peninsular rivers dry up because their main source of origin is not the snow-capped mountain. Hence, they are not receiving good amount of water in the summer, and these will dry up. The water they receive is only depending on the monsoon. And recently, climatic conditions are there, so monsoon is also not as much as it is should be. So water in peninsular river or water is drying up in during the summer, and 70% of river's water is drained into the Bay of Bengal every year, 20% in Arabian Sea, and 10% in the inland lakes. So you can see that water is unevenly distributed in India, so some parts of India are facing the water scarcity. See, in northeastern states are receiving most of the heavy rainfall during the entire year. So these areas are facing the flood every year, and in some parts of area, at the same time in some part areas of Deccan, the people are facing the drought problem. So where in one part of India, the water is there in a large quantity, at the same time in other parts of India, water scarcity is so intense that people are facing drought. Some parts of India which are facing the water scarcity are Western Maharashtra, Rajasthan, Gujarat, MP, and these are facing because of the climatic dry season. And New Delhi, Chennai, Bengaluru, Hyderabad are the metro cities or urban cities which are facing the water scarcity just because of the heavy densely population living there. About the water degradation, students, you all know that environment, because of the heavy population, because of the pollution, these are the main two reasons which are responsible for the degradation of not only the water resources but also each and every resources which we are using. Population is growing day by day, whereas resources are not able to recycle them at such a fast extent. So today we will look about how water is degraded. So student, let me tell you first that before 3 centuries ago, whatever quantity of water is used by human race by the entire world, today it is just about 45 times greater that we are using today. So now you can imagine that how much more we are depending on the water resources. 45 times means if 3 centuries ago 1,000 people were using only the 1,000 liter of water, so now that 1,000 people are using around 45,000 liter of water. So just now you can imagine that how much more consumption is there in water. Now that just not because of the 1,000 people, but before 3 centuries ago, industrialization is not there. Many processes are not there, hydroelectricity process are not there, and many processes which we are using for the recent technological and advancement are there. So water is used very less. Natural replacement rate is less than consumption. Pollution of water body is the major reason for the water degradation. Metals such as lead pollute the water. Water seeping through soil is also the reason for the contaminating the soil and reducing the soil fertility. Surface runoff of water is a very threat for the marine organisms. Mineral oils from the oil drilling plants spills, and that dissolved in the water, and that caused the threat to the marine animals. So we are the water degradation, human had degraded the water at such a vast means just because of pollution and population, entire population, these two reasons, water level and water quantity and quality, both are degraded. Students, you have heard recently about the news that Ganga water is clearing just because of lockdown. So now you can imagine that if we stop our activities, our pollution activities or our technological activity just for a few days in a year, so our environment will receive the good impact on it and they will naturally purify by itself. Now we will move towards the conservation, that how we can conserve the water for the future resources. First and foremost, storing water for the dry season is the main step. Diverting surplus water from wet regions to the dry region, that is the form of the rainwater harvesting only. Rainwater should be collected by making embankment around a low-lying area. So water should be collected there and used for future purpose. Use of sprinkles and dripping pipes in irrigation instead of using the pipes directly, because it will not only help in water conservation, it will also reduce the flow of soil by the force of water through the pipes. Water should be treated judicially before discharging it into the water bodies. Proper treatment plant should be there. Each industry should proper treatment plant should be there, so that water should be treated and then only the water, less contaminated water, should be discharged into the water bodies which does not contain harmful chemicals. Next step, there water should be conserved is we should boil water at our home to make the quality of water better. We should water should be treated with the chlorine to clear out the germs, and again we should use that water. And we should also cultivate the plants like water hyacinth, because that plants are having the capacity to filter out the toxic substance from the water naturally. So now you have learned about the degradation as well as the conservation process. So students, we all are human beings. We have to depend on these basic resources for survival. So it is up to us that we should use that water resources judicially, so that we should also use them and our future generation will also consume that resources and live their life in a better way. I hope this chapter is clear to you. I will meet you in the next video with the next topic. Till then, take care. Bye.